Hello, everybody. So we're going to do take two, or round two rather, of crawfish etouffee. We're going to give you a little tutorial and a recipe on how we do it. We had last weekend, me and Elisa, we went and bought a sack of live crawfish. We boiled them. We had about 10 to 15 pounds left over. So we peeled those tails, froze them, thawed them out for today to cook a crawfish etouffee with the remaining tails. So here we go. Got our stick of butter in there. About a tablespoon of garlic, heaping tablespoon. Okay, so the butter's melted. You want to go in with your half a cup of flour. You want to stir. Okay, so I've been stirring the roux for about 8 to 10 minutes. We got a good chocolate, kind of brown color, light brown color, dark blonde, if you will. The garlic in there is nice and toasted. So now we're going to go ahead and add in our freshly cut mirepoix, which consists of onion. We have two onions chopped. We have one bell pepper chopped, and we have about eight pieces of celery that we chopped. Come in with our onion and with our bell pepper. And with our.
And show what a good job you did chopping all that.
Yeah, I want to cut all that beforehand.
Yeah.
And the green onions for later. And then we'll stir that in there. It's going to thicken up real good. Just absorbs all that butter and that garlic. That's what you want. So now we want to add in our chicken stock, about 2 cups. Okay, add that in. I'm going to let that cook, bring it up to a boil, and then cut it back down to simmer. Let it cook for a little while, and then we'll add in our tomatoes. A little bit of brown seasoning sauce, just to get the color right. Trial and error with this. A little bit goes a long way. Pour a little bit. Stir a little bit. You get the color you want. And one to grill on. There we go. That's what we're looking at right there. Got the color. That's the color we want.
Yeah. We need to simmer, what, about 20 minutes?
And let that simmer down. We're going to bring it back up to a bowl and let it cook, thicken up a little bit, and we're going to add our tomatoes. So, probably 10 minutes or so.
Okay.
Take a couple bay leaves, go in there, stir them around. Taste it. Okay, time to add salt. A couple teaspoons. Garlic powder. Probably say about 2 teaspoons of each. Onion powder. couple dashes of cayenne pepper.
Oh, it smells so good.
Get another spoon, clean spoon. Taste again. Always want to taste along the way. A little more salt. Oh, and we forgot one other ingredient. Tony Satcheries.
Tony's goes in everything we cook.
Especially Cajun food, like crawfish etouffee. Maybe just a couple teaspoons of that as well. Nice tomatoes. Taste. We're getting there. Down to simmer and let it cook for about another 10 minutes or so.
Update.
Okay, so it's been about 10 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
And we're just letting it cook because you don't want to rush it. The longer it cooks, the more those flavors kind of mix together. And that mirepoix, the raw onion and the celery and the bell pepper, you want that to be cooked down and be soft and tender. So that's what we're doing. That's the goal right now. So we're going to cover it back and maybe let it go for about another 5 minutes just to make sure. Because you can't overcook this, as long as you put it on a nice low simmer and don't burn it. Just let it cook. The longer the better. But we're going to give it about another 5 minutes, and then we're probably going to go ahead and add the crawfish. You want to add the crawfish at the very end because they're already cooked, and you don't want to cook them anymore. You just kind of want to add them at the end along with the green onions, okay? Okay, so we're about 20-25 minutes in. We just let it cook. We had the boys come in from drill meet, so I just let it cook a little longer, which is fine. It's all getting happy. So we're gonna go ahead and add in the crawfish. Okay, we got about
1.5 pounds of crawfish.
Yeah, about 1.5 pounds of crawfish. We're gonna go ahead and ease those in here like this.
Mmm.
This is when it really gets happy. Okay. Stir them in.
Oh yeah.
You see it now? Coming together? Make sure you take your bay leaves out if you don't want to eat those. Alright? Stir all that together. Three handfuls. Hands are clean. They've been washed.
Oh man, it's beautiful. Look at all those colors.
Alright. And we'll serve it up and show you. It's just about ready to serve now. We'll go ahead and cover it for a couple of more, just maybe a couple of minutes.
Let this crawfish get warm.
Let this crawfish get good and warm and let those flavors of the crawfish seep into the roux. And then we'll serve it with some rice, a scoop of rice on the top, okay? We'll show you that in just a minute.
Is it ready?
Yep, so it's ready. So we're gonna make a plate. A couple ladles. Our crawfish, and pack that rice in there with an ice cream scoop. top. And garnish it with a little bit of chopped green onion and some parsley.
Oh, that's pretty.
And there you go. Crawfish etouffee, y'all.
Look at that. That's beautiful. And that's the finished product in the pot. Look at that. Bon appetit. Since the beginning, it hadn't changed yet. I said something.